Hello everyone, with this video I am going to start a video lecture series on lipid metabolism which will cover major metabolic pathways and their regulation and important cases related to the topic. This video on overview of lipid metabolism will help you to understand the overall concept of lipid metabolism. Acetyl-CoA is the central molecule of lipid metabolism. It is derived from pyruvate by the action of enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase, and pyruvate is the end product of glycolysis. Acetyl-CoA can also be derived from carbon skeleton of some amino acids. In fasting and starvation, triacylglycerol, which is stored in adipose tissue, it is broken down into fatty acids and glycerol. Fatty acids are further oxidized to form acetyl-CoA. Now, what is the fate of this acetyl-CoA in well-fed condition? Let's see. The acetyl-CoA undergoes TCA cycle. Reducing equivalents are generated in TCA cycle, which undergoes electron transport chain to generate energy currency of the cell, that is ATP. Second fate is fatty acid synthesis. The fatty acids which are synthesized, they are stored in the form of triacylglycerol in adipose tissue in well-fed condition. The next fate of acetyl-CoA is, it is the substrate for cholesterol synthesis. What happens in fasting and starvation? The acetyl-CoA, which is formed by lipolysis and beta oxidation from triacylglycerol, there is synthesis of ketone bodies occur in mitochondria, and these ketone bodies are utilized by various cells in the body in starvation. Mostly the brain is dependent on glucose as well as ketone bodies as a source of fuel in starvation. Let's understand major metabolic pathways of lipid in two states, well-fed state and fasting and starvation. So what are the major metabolic pathways in well-fed state? First is digestion and absorption of dietary lipids. This is the first major metabolic pathway. Second, de novo synthesis of fatty acids. Third is storage of that fatty acid in the form of triacylglycerol. So triacylglycerol synthesis and its storage. Next is lipoprotein metabolism, which will cover the metabolism of various lipoproteins like chylomicron, VLDL, LDL, HDL, their important functions and disorders associated with the lipoprotein metabolism, cholesterol synthesis, and compound lipid synthesis. That is phospholipids, glycolipids, these are the compound lipids. So in well-fed condition, these major metabolic pathways occur in the body. And this well-fed state is governed by the hormone insulin. Insulin plays a very important role and which regulates all these metabolic pathways. Now what happens in fasting and starvation, which are the important pathways? Lipolysis. In case of fasting and starvation, triacylglycerol, which are stored in the adipose tissue, they are lipolyzed. So TAG is converted into fatty acid and glycerol, that is called as lipolysis. Then fatty acids undergo oxidation, so that is fatty acid oxidation. And in starvation, ketone body synthesis occurs. So ketone body synthesis and its utilization, these major pathways occur in fasting and starvation. And this state is governed by two important hormones, glucagon and epinephrine. What is the cellular location of major metabolic pathways? Fatty acid synthesis occurs in cytosol. Cholesterol synthesis occurs in cytosol as well as in endoplasmic reticulum. Some enzymes are located in cytosol and some are in endoplasmic reticulum. Fatty acid oxidation occurs in mitochondria and ketone body synthesis also occurs in mitochondria. In the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, compound lipid synthesis occurs, for example, phospholipid synthesis, and triacylglycerol synthesis, that is lipogenesis, also occur in smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Now let's try to understand various major metabolic pathways with this schematic representation. This is a cell, this is cytosol, this is mitochondria. Let's begin with the central molecule of lipid metabolism, and that is acetyl-CoA. It is derived from pyruvate by the action of enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase. And from where this pyruvate is derived? It is end product of glycolysis. What is the fate of acetyl-CoA? The first fate is it undergoes TCA cycle. And later on, the second fate is synthesis of fatty acids. But acetyl-CoA cannot cross this mitochondrial membrane. So it combines with oxaloacetate to form citrate. And this citrate now can cross this mitochondrial membrane. It comes in cytosol. Then it is broken down to form acetyl-CoA and oxaloacetate. And this acetyl-CoA, which is formed, it is involved in fatty acid synthesis. So fatty acid synthesis occurs in well-fed state. Now these fatty acids are stored in adipose tissue in the form of triacylglycerol. The fatty acids in well-fed condition are also derived from chylomicrons and VLDL. Now for storage of fatty acid in the form of triacylglycerol, what is required besides fatty acid? Glycerol is required. So this is the active form of glycerol, glycerol 3-phosphate. And what is the source? It is derived from dihydroxyacetone phosphate. So glycerol and fatty acids together form triacylglycerol, which are then stored in adipose tissues in well-fed condition. And this triacylglycerol will later be utilized during fasting and starvation by the process of lipolysis and later beta-oxidation. The acetyl-CoA pool, whenever there is increased acetyl-CoA pool, there is synthesis of cholesterol occurs from the acetyl-CoA. It is also a substrate for cholesterol synthesis. So these are the pathways which occur in well-fed condition. Now what happens in fasting and starvation? In fasting and starvation, these triacylglycerol are broken down by the process of lipolysis. So triacylglycerol are broken down into fatty acids and glycerol. What is the fate of these fatty acids? These fatty acids are activated to form fatty acyl-CoA. And this fatty acyl-CoA then enters mitochondria through this carnitine shuttle. And these fatty acyl-CoA, the fatty acids undergo beta-oxidation. And acetyl-CoA is the end product of beta-oxidation. Then whenever there is increased beta-oxidation and increased production of acetyl-CoA, which cannot be utilized in the TCA cycle, so there is synthesis of ketone bodies. Acetyl-CoA is also the substrate for synthesis of ketone bodies. Now what happens to the glycerol, that is the product of lipolysis? This glycerol is converted back into dihydroxyacetone phosphate, which is the intermediate of glycolysis. And it has two fates. It can undergo glycolysis to form pyruvate, or it can be utilized for the synthesis of glucose, that it can undergo gluconeogenesis. So this is the major metabolic pathway or various pathways that occur in well-fed condition and in starvation. Regulation of major metabolic pathways occurs by four important mechanisms. The first is availability of substrate. Second, allosteric regulation. Third, covalent modifications. And fourth is induction or repression, which occurs at gene level. Overall, the major metabolic pathways of lipid, how they are regulated by availability of substrate, let's see. So increased pyruvate leads to increased acetyl-CoA. So whenever there is increased acetyl-CoA in well-fed condition, leads to increased synthesis of citrate, which is further utilized for fatty acid synthesis. So increased availability of citrate is diverted to fatty acid synthesis. In fasting and starvation, oxidation of fatty acid leads to increased availability of acetyl-CoA, and this acetyl-CoA will be further utilized for ketone body synthesis in case of starvation. Second is allosteric regulation. Acetyl-CoA carboxylase is the important rate limiting enzyme of fatty acid synthesis, and citrate is the allosteric activator of acetyl-CoA carboxylase. So in well-fed condition, citrate activates acetyl-CoA carboxylase and thus it favors fatty acid synthesis. We know that insulin is the hormone of well-fed condition. It governs the well-fed state and it regulates major metabolic pathways by covalent modification and by induction. It causes dephosphorylation of enzymes. acetyl CoA carboxylase is the enzyme rate limiting enzyme of fatty acid synthesis, and it is active in dephosphorylated condition, and thus insulin favors fatty acid synthesis. Hormone sensitive lipase is the enzyme of lipolysis. It causes breakdown of triacylglycerol into fatty acid and glycerol, and this enzyme, hormone sensitive lipase, it is inactive when it is dephosphorylated. Thus insulin causes its dephosphorylation and makes it inactive, and thus inhibits lipolysis. Insulin also induces synthesis of certain enzymes at gene level, and the examples are: first, acetyl CoA carboxylase. It induces synthesis of acetyl CoA carboxylase and favors fatty acid synthesis. Insulin induces synthesis of HMG CoA reductase, which is the rate limiting enzyme of cholesterol synthesis. Thus, insulin favors cholesterol synthesis also. Now let's talk about glucagon. It is the enzyme of fasting, hormone of fasting and starvation. Glucagon causes phosphorylation, and acetyl CoA carboxylase is inactive in phosphorylated condition, and thus glucagon inhibits fatty acid synthesis. Glucagon phosphorylates hormone sensitive lipase, and this enzyme is active when it is phosphorylated, and thus glucagon activates lipolysis. What is the role of epinephrine? Epinephrine also causes phosphorylation like glucagon, and it causes phosphorylation of hormone sensitive lipase, and also it induces lipolysis. So this is how the major metabolic pathways are regulated by four important mechanisms, and the hormones insulin, glucagon and epinephrine, they play a very important role in the regulation of various major metabolic pathways of lipid metabolism. Now let's talk briefly about the action of various lipases in lipid metabolism. First, lipase is lingual and gastric lipase. Site of action is mouth and stomach, but the digestion of lipids in mouth is insignificant. It begins in stomach, and the substrate for lingual and gastric lipase is triacylglycerol, small and medium chain fatty acids, which are present in milk. That's why these enzymes are important in neonates. And the product which are formed are free fatty acids and diacylglycerol. The second enzyme, second lipase is pancreatic lipase. The site of action is duodenum, and this pancreatic lipase is synthesized from exocrine cells of pancreas. In the duodenum, this pancreatic lipase act on long chain fatty acid containing triacylglycerol, and the products which are formed are free fatty acid glycerol and 2-monoacylglycerol. Third is intestinal lipase. The site of action is small intestine, and the substrate is triacylglycerol containing medium chain fatty acid, and the products formed are free fatty acids and glycerol. Then phospholipase A2, which is secreted by pancreas. Site of action is small intestine, and the substrate is phospholipids. This phospholipase A2 acts at the C2 carbon position, and it breaks down fatty acid at C2 position to form free fatty acid and lysolecithin. Then comes lipoprotein lipase. This lipoprotein lipase are present in the capillary walls of important tissues like adipose tissues and muscles, and the substrate are triacylglycerol in VLDL and chylomicrons. So lipoprotein lipase acts on triacylglycerol, which are there in VLDL and chylomicrons, to form free fatty acids and glycerol, and this free fatty acid then will be utilized in the adipose tissue and muscles. The next lipase is hormone sensitive lipase. Site of action is adipose tissue. They act on triacylglycerol stores which are there in the adipose tissues. It is important in fasting and starvation, and it breaks down triacylglycerol into free fatty acids and glycerol. So this is the enzyme of fasting and starvation. Next is hepatic lipase. Site of action is liver, and this enzyme breaks down triacylglycerol which are there in the VLDL remnant, IDL, and it is also involved in HDL remodeling, that is conversion of HDL2 into HDL free, and the products formed are free fatty acids and glycerol.